The first step is to enable Eco Mode to be visible by turning it on. For this, you go to General Settings and scroll down to 1170 Auto Start and press Enter. If you are running a compressor with dual outlets, you will need to instruct the controller which outlet to monitor the pressure on. First, we will look at the Auto Load, Unload feature. To activate, you have to press the Load button before you start the compressor. The Eco Mode screen will pop up, and you can program for your specific requirements. The hand icon indicates the function is set to manual. The options that come up from left to right are Auto Start, Auto Load Unload, and Auto Stop. Use the arrow to navigate to the load icon. Activate it with the Enter button. Both a timer and pressure valve will appear to use the arrow buttons to move the cursor and set the timer. This will dictate how long the unit idles before it goes into a no load state. Use the Enter button to confirm. Use the arrow buttons to move the cursor and set the pressure points where the unit will automatically load again. Use the Enter button to confirm. Once all of the parameters have been set, you must confirm. Set the cursor on the OK button and press Enter. Now, the Eco Mode icon will appear on the controller. You are now set to Eco Mode and can start the compressor. Now we will start up the machine and let it run through its warm-up cycle. For today's demonstration, we have simulated an application using a receiver tank, and we are monitoring the application pressure with the gauge on the right. When the unit starts and there's air demand, everything runs the same. Once there is no demand on the compressor, it will return to idle at an unload state, and our timer will start. You will notice in today's setup, we are using an XAS 1800 C13B unit with pace controls. This unit is consuming approximately 8 gallons an hour while in a loaded state. Once the preset time is reached, the unit will go into a no-load state, thus relieving the air pressure in the pressure vessel and lowering the load on the engine, which will reduce the fuel consumption by roughly 50%. You can see it is now consuming roughly 4 gallons an hour. The unit will now run indefinitely until the system pressure between the minimum pressure valve on the compressor and the application drops below your set point. Note that if your system has air leaks, then the system may gradually lose pressure, and that it will turn the unit on again to bring the pressure back up. Once the sensor drops below the set point, it will load back up quickly, and you are ready to go to work. Now, let's take a closer look at the Auto Start Stop feature. You will use the same setup procedure as we did with the Auto Load Unload. Use the arrow to navigate to the Auto Stop icon. Use the Enter button to confirm. Set the time before the unit stops and the pressure at which it restarts. Now we will start up the machine and let it run through its warm-up cycle. We are now simulating an air demand by this application. Once there is no demand on the compressor, it will return to idle at an unloaded state, and our timer will start. Once the preset time is reached, the unit will go to a shutdown sequence by reducing the vessel pressure and going through an engine cooldown sequence before turning off. Once the sensor drops below the preset pressure point, the unit will go through its startup sequence and bring the air back online. Please refer to the operator's manual or contact our technical service team for further assistance to set up eco mode.